Hi, I'm Alisha from adultspeechtherapy.co. And in today's video, I thought I'd show you how to complete oral care. So unfortunately, I only have a toothbrush at my house, but I want to show you how to complete the oral care in a patient. And we're going to pretend that this is an oral toothette. So the toothettes are what you find, you know, skilled nursing, hospitals, inpatient rehab, and they're usually on a white stick and they have the little sponge on the tip that has the pink or the green, and they have sometimes a little bit of flavoring on them. So why oral care? Oral care, we are the keepers of the mouth as a speech language pathologist. So oral care is huge. It helps prevent bacteria in the mouth, which can lead to aspiration pneumonia. So we really want to keep a good eye on patients' mouths. Even on a regular diet, patients should have diligent oral care. And so I thought I'd show you how to complete it, because I know when I was first into the field and as a CFY, nobody showed me how to complete oral care. I just kind of went in there and was like, okay, I guess I'll just move my sponge around in their mouth. But we really want to be careful about it. So especially if a patient is having some pocketing, that's a really important time to be keeping an eye on their oral care. And so what I do with oral care is I will take my sponge and I will dip it into a little glass of water and make sure when they are NPO, a big thing is to squeeze the sponge out so that water is not gonna drip right down into their throat and they could potentially aspirate it. So that's a really big thing to remember. So I'll dip it into some water, squeeze out the sponge. Again, I would be wearing gloves, and then I would proceed to their mouth. So it's really helpful to have a flashlight. If you have your phone with the flashlight on the back of it, that's fine. If you have a pen light, even better. And you wanna be able to see everything that you're working with. So I'll have the patient open their mouth as wide as they can. And I like to, there's no real order that you have to do it, but at first, just get a good look in there, and then making sure you're getting all surfaces. So inside the cheeks, all around the bottom of the gum line, cheeks, again, gum line. You can even take your hand and looking here. If they're unable to open their mouth very big, you could take a tongue depressor, help push their cheek over, then taking their tongue, have them stick it out as far as they can, scrubbing the tongue. All around the teeth. All surfaces of the teeth. Then don't forget under the tongue. Again, that would be a good time that you could actually take a washcloth and hold their tongue and move it over side to side, or if they're able to turn it like that, that's just fine too. And then make sure to chuck the palate. That is where a lot of that dried secretions end up, unfortunately. And so sometimes if it's just stuck on there, you're going to have to scrub it for a length of time until you can remove it. And if they have really poor difficulties managing their secretions, you're going to want to bring in your suction to help you pull it off as well and keep hold of it so it doesn't fall back into their throat. So palate as far as you can without initiating the gag reflex. That's uncomfortable. Again, so going through that the best you can. I really, really try to emphasize, you know, my patients to complete oral care. Nurses, you know, on board with that is huge. And especially if they're having pocketing, we have to be checking for that and then using the oral care throughout their mouth so there's no residual bacteria from their food or liquids. A lot of times often patients with oral thrush, they need better oral care as well, but be careful because it is quite sensitive. So their tongue, cheek, palate, it can be sensitive. So just be careful when you're rubbing in there with the toothette. Again, I'm emphasizing making sure it is wet. Now, sometimes when I'm doing my oral care and I'm using the wet toothette on the top of the roof of the mouth or palate, and you know, I just need to really scrape a little bit more and I can't get it. The wet toothette is not pulling it off. So I will take my suction and then take a dry toothette and help remove sometimes large pieces of dried mucus. So that really is helpful, having that suction set up as well. And you can always ask your nurse or respiratory therapist to assist you with setting up your suction if you don't know how to. So again, oral care is huge. Hopefully you have access to plentiful amount of those toothettes and a cup. You can grab tongue depressors, flashlight on your phone, flashlight or pen light, and have those handy with you for all patients. And just emphasize, if they are totally cognitively intact, they're on a regular diet, you still want to emphasize brushing your teeth. So they're brushing their teeth with a regular toothbrush at this time and able to complete their own oral care. So the toothette versus a toothbrush, again, the toothette I'm using for patients, usually when they're on a modified liquids, or textures, they have significant weakness, they're NPO, and I will be using the toothette. And it is uncomfortable to use a toothbrush sometimes on your palate or inner cheeks, so you can use a toothette and then you can switch over to a toothbrush. So again, the toothbrush is going to be more powerful for the teeth and the tongue, but it is more sensitive on the palate and the cheeks. So I hope this was informative, giving you a little bit more information about how to complete oral care. I can't emphasize it enough how important it is, especially for our patients who've had a stroke, or maybe you're trying to advance them to a Fraser Water protocol. For everything else, including free PDFs, be sure to check out adultspeechtherapy.co.